Good day, students. Welcome to part one of my slope fields and installment. In this tutorial, we're going to be going over how to determine the equation, the differential equation given a slope or direction field. Okay, so the instructions are as follows. Determine the differential equation that could be represented with the given slope fields. For number one, we have this circular slope field right here. And the question is, which of these differential equation results in this slope field, okay? All right, so we know the whole idea behind a slope field. We have a differential equation. You know, if you solve a differential equation, that C component gives you a family of curves that are the solutions of the differential equation. So this slope field basically tells you the slope of the tangent line at each point on the family of curves that represents the solution to this differential equation. So you want to associate this slope field to a particular solution, we have to find the initial value, okay? All right, so let's see how we can determine which of these equations could be represented by this slope field. So the quickest way to do it, we can do this using method of elimination. So first thing we're going to do is take a look at the slopes, the slope field. These are all tangent lines. And you ask yourself, are they all identical? If they are all identical, that tells you that the slope field is independent of the x or y values. It's a constant slope field. In that case, your derivative, your differential equation is going to be equal to a constant, all right? So if you look at this slope field, do you notice that they're all the same? Do they have the same steepness, so to speak? This is steeper than this. You see the steepness is decreasing, and then it hits zero, and then it goes into the negative area. So we can see that it's not constant, all right? Since it's not constant, we know that dy dx equals to constant cannot be the answer. So we can eliminate option A. Option A would have been true if the entire slope field had identical slopes, okay? Or steepness. All right, now that we've eliminated one option, we're down to four. What we're going to do is we're going to fix one variable and ask ourselves how the other variable impacts the steepness of the slope field, okay? So let's fix our, how about we fix our y first, all right? So we're gonna fix our y. Let's use our red one here, red. All right, so if I wanna, let me just pick this region up here. So I'm gonna take this entire region, y equals two. I'm gonna fix my y and I'm gonna ask myself the following question. With y fixed and x varying, does the steepness of the line change? View these as tangent lines, sections of tangent lines, okay? Is the steepness of the tangent line changing? The answer is absolutely yes. So since it's changing, that means that x is going to be present in the differential equation, okay? All right, let's do take a look at the other orientation, okay? So in the other orientation, we're going to look at fixing the x. Let's fix the x at x equals positive 2, for example. Okay, x equals positive 2. See how that looks like. And then I'm going to let's fix it right here. Okay, now look at the slope lines right here, these tangent lines, okay? If we hold x fixed, all right, and we allow y to attain different values, does the alteration or the variability of the y value impact the steepness of the line? The answer is yes. You notice that the slope of each line is different, right? Here is undefined, here is negative, and here it's positive, decreasing in steepness, so to speak, okay? So it's increasing, gets to undefined, and then it gets to negative, and then starts to continue increasing again. So this means that y is going to be present in the differential equation, okay? So since we, after doing our two investigations, we know that in the differential equation, y and x are present. They must be present in the differential equation because they both impact the steepness of the line. So what we're going to do is look at our alternatives and ask ourselves, which of these ones has either x or y alone, okay? The answer is option B. Option B has only an x, okay? So this cannot be a possible solution because x and y impact, play a role, and this has only x. This equation is telling us that y doesn't play a role, only x plays a role. But in our investigation just now, we found out that both variables play a role, okay? All right, now we have three options. Now it's easy for us to determine which one the answer is. So what we do is we examine our slope field, and we can look at the extreme cases, for example. This is an extreme case right here. What is the slope of this line? This has an undefined tangent line, okay? It has an undefined tangent line at when y is 0. So that point right there is 1, 0. So when y is 0, we notice that we have a vertical tangent line or an undefined slope. So look at all these three candidates that we have. Which one will result to an undefined output when y is 0? If you look at options C and D, these two differential equations never result in a vertical tangent because they do not have any variable in their denominator, okay? So it can never be C, it cannot be D. You can clearly see that E is the answer because if we plug in the points on this slope right here, we're going to get negative 1 over 0, which is undefined, right? And this is exactly what the slope of an undefined line looks like, okay? So we see that the answer for number 1 is option E, okay? All right, now let's take a look at number 2. So we're going to do the same process. Let's examine the slope fields first and see if there is a pattern that we can determine. Now, what do you notice about the steepness of all the lines? You notice that all the lines have exactly the same steepness. What does that tell you? It tells you that this slope field is independent of x or y. It is a constant slope field. All right, so the question is, which variables are going to be present? The answer is none, neither x nor y, because it's independent of both. So you need to look for the option that has neither x nor y on it, a differential equation that's equal to a constant. This has x and y, cannot be, this cannot be. Bam, there goes the answer right there, option C. This is the only one that satisfies this slope field right here. Cannot be this, cannot be that. All right? So let's see, does this answer make sense? This answer tells us that the slope, the tangent line will always have a steepness of negative 1 at everywhere in the entire slope field. Is that the case here? Absolutely. Every single slope tangent line has a slope of negative 1. Okay, if you extend it, extrapolate it, let me show you what I'm talking about here. So if you look at this line right here, from here to here, what's the steepness of that line? You drop 1, negative 1, you run 1. So you see the slope of this line is negative 1, and that's the slope of all the tangent lines in our slope field. All right, so our answer is option C. So what I'm trying to highlight here, the different ways you can find the answer, but I just want you to see that the connection or the shortcuts that you can use to determine what the graph is without actually doing any calculations whatsoever. All right, let's take a look at the next question number 3. All right, let's take a look at this slope field. Let's see if we can do some elimination here. All right, first thing we're going to do, look at all the tangent lines. Do they all have identical steepness? The answer is absolutely not, okay? This is positive, less positive, 0, negative, and more negative, all right? So we know that it cannot be equal to a constant, so we can easily eliminate option letter E, okay? Now let's look at the impact that each variable has on this slope field. First thing we're going to look at, let's look at the impact that y has. To determine the impact, or let's look at the impact that x has. To determine the impact that x has, we're going to we're going to hold y fixed, okay? So what we're going to do is draw a horizontal line. We want to fix y to a value of 2, okay? If y has a value of 2, constantly 2, and x is allowed to attain multiple values, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, does the variation of x impact the steepness of the tangent line? The answer is absolutely. So that tells us that x is present. X must be present, okay? X must be present in the differential equation. Now let's take a look at the y. Does y impact the steepness of the lines in our slope field here? Let's use a blue line. So let's pick this x value. So we're going to fix x at a value of positive 1. Now let's take a look at this region right here. When x is constantly negative positive 1 and y is allowed to attain multiple values, namely 2, 1, 0, negative 1, negative 2, y is allowed to have multiple values. Does that impact the steepness of the line? The answer is no. So what does this tell us? It tells us that this differential this slope field is independent of y. So that means that y is going to be absent from the differential equation. All right? So just looking at that pattern alone, we can eliminate answers right here, okay? So let's look for the equations that have x and y or just y. Okay, this has y, can never be the answer because this is dependent solely on y. This has just y, cannot be the answer. This has x, this is a candidate, and this has x, this is also a candidate. So our answer is either option C or option letter D. So which one is the answer? Well, this is an easy one to determine because if you take a look at these two differential equations, this guarantees that the slope will always be positive because you're squaring your inputs, okay? And this will give you basically the opposite of your input. So if, let's say, you input positive 1, your slope is going to be negative or 1, all right? So since this is always positive, do we have slope lines here that have a negative steepness? Tangent lines here with a negative steepness. The answer is yes. Look at all these lines to the right here. They all have negative slopes. So this cannot be the answer. Your answer is option letter D. All right? So that's that. All right, now let's move on to the last problem, problem number 4. All right, so for number 4, if you look at the slope field, you notice that they are all different. So we know that it cannot be a constant. So we can quickly eliminate option letter B. All right, let's see what this slope field is independent of. So let's take a look at how y impacts this slope field by fixing our x. Okay? So if I fix x to negative 2, do the slope of the tangent lines change? The answer is yes, they change, right? So that means that y is going to be present in the differential equation. So y has to be present. All right, now let's fix our y and look at the impact that the variability of x has on the steepness of the line, okay? So if I fix y at negative 1 and I let x vary, does that impact the steepness of the tangent lines to the solution of my differential equation? The answer is no. Since they all have the same slope, it tells me that this equation is this slope field is independent of x. Hence, x is going to be absent from the differential equation. Okay? All right, so any equation that has x and y or just x cannot be the differential equation. Okay, so this cannot be, and this cannot be. So our answer is either C or E. Okay, so how do we know which one is the correct one? This one was easy, option number three, because we could use exploit the fact that this is a square and only has positive outputs, so we could figure that out, but this is not the case. So in order to determine what the correct answer is, we're just going to pick a point, all right? So we can pick this point right here. Easy point, 1, 0. Pick the point 0, 1. So if I input 0, 1 into these two differential equations, which would give me a slope that's something like this. This line looks like a line with a slope of negative 1, right? So let's see. If I plug in 0, 1, which gives me a slope of negative 1. So if I, let's test this equation first. Option C, we have y prime is equal to negative 1 over y. So at 0, 1 is going to be negative 1 over 1, which is negative 1. Exactly, perfect. This is what I'm looking for. So this is the correct answer. If I tested option E, let me put a check mark here. This is good. If I tested option E, what would have happened? If I tested option E, y prime equals 1 over y. If I input my y value into this differential equation, I will get 1 over 1, which is 1, which is a line that has a positive slope. But we can see that the steepness of this tangent line right here is negative. So option E is not the answer. The final answer is option letter C. Okay? So that's that. So thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Feel free to subscribe to my channel by clicking up here. And please post a comment to let me know what you think about this presentation. More clips can be found on microsoft.com/calculus. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.